Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Tubaplyr, NegativeAE, and this is possibly the last episode. I don't know how long these cast trials go. Let me ask you again.
Did you go to the storage room during the blackout?
There's no way I went to the storage room. I was somewhere totally different.
I definitely heard Taro Taro's voice. It's handsome, unlike his face. Maybe it was a recording or something? Nope, definitely a live voice.
Right, as long as I have her testimony. The fact that I was in the dining hall cannot be disputed.
Okay. The contradiction between... There's definitely a contradiction hidden between those remarks. I need to find it.
Let me ask you again.
That's
Did you go to the storage room during the blackout?
There's no way I went to the storage room. I was somewhere totally different.
But he wasn't in the room after the thing.
I definitely heard Taro Taro's voice.
Yes, you did.
It's handsome, unlike his face.
Maybe it was a recording or something?
No.
Nope, definitely a live voice.
It's a live voice.
Right, as long as I have her testimony.
Yeah.
The fact that I was in the dining hall cannot be disputed.
Get out of
I'll
my life.
Through that contradiction.
Son? What are you doing?
Just because we heard Taro Taro's voice in the dining hall doesn't mean he was literally in the dining hall.
Huh? Why?
Remember the floor in the dining hall? It was full of gaps, right? So even if you shouted from under the floor, it should have sounded just like the voices in the dining hall.
So he brazenly shouted from under the floor to make us think he was in the dining.
Yeah, but he wasn't there afterwards.
Is that true, Taro Taro?
Hold on a second.
Can you explain this, Taro Taro?
I told you to wait a second, ain't I? What are y'all even saying anymore? I'm telling you, I was in that there dining hall during the blackout.
Where are you from again?
Ooh, I was born in West Asafu and raised in South Aoyama.
Hey, you guys, this guy's a major liar.
If Taro Taro was in the dining hall during the blackout, he should have been there after the power was
out. And he wasn't.
Right?
Well, I believe so. There's no way he could have gone back and forth in that dark hallway.
Huh? Was Taro Taro actually there during that time?
I sure was! I was there the whole damn time!
Something like this shouldn't be decided by gut instinct. People's lives are at stake.
Damn right! You guys should have been deciding this on the spot with your hazy memories!
His accent is getting even worse! He's definitely lying!
However, I am not sure. I believe that he was there, and I believe that he was not there.
Sonya, never mind.
No.
I'm going to
is
punch
there any
you.
Way we can decide?
Why don't we consult his memories?
Okay.
Right, yeah, don't be saying things like that don't make no sense. Can you even prove I wasn't in the data hall?
Probably can.
Oh, you again!
Whether or not Teteru was in the dining hall during the blackout, in order to know for sure, I need to throw a question at him. Boom.
I can prove it with this.
Yeah, what happened here?
If you're claiming that you were in the dining hall when the power came back, then you should know how Mikan was positioned at the time. Right.
Whoa, what?
No! Don't make me remember! It's so embarrassing!
No, this is a very important question. Well, Taro Taro, if you were really in the dining hall at that time, you should know the answer.
Yeah, dude.
To that.
Huh? Freaking answer it, dude.
It was a pretty clever way of tripping. There's no way you'd forget about it so easily.
I'm so sorry. I showed you something so unsightly.
How about it? You can't answer, Taro Taro?
That's weird.
Yeah, but you're a pervert, so it wouldn't.
There's no way it would slip from your mind, especially not a pervert like you.
Boom. See, me and Mahiru are on the same page.
Nagito, say something!
I guess you might have to give up now.
Give up?
What do you mean, give up?
Teru Teru, I'm disappointed too, you know. It's lonely watching someone I admire reach the limits of their hope. It kind of feels like a broken dream.
Nagito, what are you doing? Why are you messing with the killer like that?
Hold on a sec. Don't go moving this along on your own like I really am the killer.
Huh? But it's already decided,
oh,
right?
Do not throw another twist.
No matter what, it hasn't been cleared up yet, Jeff.
No use. I can't understand him anymore.
It appears he's saying the murder weapon hasn't been cleared up yet.
You understand him?
But it's such a sad defense. This is too cruel.
Oh, you calling me the killer, then where the weapon?
You call me the killer, then wear the weapon.
Come on, Manumi. Enough with the whimpering and translate.
He said, if you're calling me the killer, then where's the weapon?
Weapon, huh? Yeah, it's not the knife, right?
Yeah.
Judging from Yaku's wounds, it was a thin-edged tool that's roughly 5 millimeters in diameter.
Also, okay. If they stabbed from under the floorboards, the weapon would need to be at least 50 centimeters in length.
After all this, who cares about the weapon?
Not good enough at all!
He said, not good enough. Not good enough at all.
Fine, I got it. Let's try thinking about what the weapon was.
Wanna do it?
He said, try to do it.
What a confusing accent.
All right, you need to focus on the thing, man. Edge tool, but I think the weapon needs to might have been, what's that? Hangman's Gambit. Done.
I got it.
Let's go.
That's it. The weapon must be the Iron Skewer.
Huh? The Iron Skewer?
Before the party, as Byagyo was confiscating all the dangerous items, he spoke to Teru Teru.
That's been missing from the start.
So that missing iron skewer is the weapon?
An iron skewer would match up with the wounds perfectly.
Hey, Teru Teru, where'd you hide the iron skewer?
Avril Lavigne!
Avril Lavigne?
Avril Lavigne?
Huh? Did he really just say that?
He's just saying random shit to fuck with us. You probably dumped it somewhere on the island, didn't you?
This school trip has a no littering rule. If he had violated it, the island sirens would be ringing non-stop.
Island sirens? Just for littering?
Also, I was on guard duty, and I never once saw Teru Teru leave the old building.
Which means he obviously hid it somewhere in the old building.
It's probably the kitchen again, right?
Teru Teru, just man up and be straight with us.
Finally, we are nearing the end. A cornered opponent will be surrounded by soul shields and simply will not listen to what you have to say. It'll probably pain you to condemn your classmate, but this is a class trial after all. You must argue against your opponent and destroy their soul shields. A high-speed dispute battle where you beat down a panicked opponent's excuses and nonsense. That's the bullet time the panic talk action. PTA. During PTA, you must destroy all of your opponent's soul shields so you can deliver your final strike. In order to do that, you must destroy the opponent's remarks following the tempo of the song. Press your button with the tempo marker as it moves across the screen. I'm good at this. Lock on to your opponent. If pressing it, you will be able to lock on to more afterward if you release. I don't know. It's too many things. I learn by doing. However, if you cannot, you end up getting hurt. During the PTA, you can press the escape key to view the controls. But for this PTA, just focus on pressing the left mouse button. There will be another time for other features. Do this consecutively, you start a combo. Keep this going, you'll get an initiated tempo up. On the flip side, if you keep missing, you find yourself in a tempo down situation. When the song changes, the tempo changes. This will alter the timings, please be careful, but last but not least, let me tell you about the final blow. If you destroy your opponent's soul shields, this will give their final argument. The If that happens, four words will be displayed to the top, bottom, and left side, left and right side of the screen. These four words come from the WASD keys. If you press the right order, your words of your final strike. Dots, dots. Please make sure your argument searching for the words that will trump your opponent's final argument. If you do not deliver your final strike, your opponent's soul shields will recover. Well then, good luck and have fun.
Oh. What the hell is that a YouTuber cutter, eh?
He said, what the hell are you even saying, you stupid country neck?
I guess we have no choice but to somehow find out for ourselves.
The iron screw is the weapon, and hiding it in the kitchen would be the easiest way to slip it by. But Byakuya and I checked the kitchen pretty thoroughly before the party started, which means the weapon was already hidden somewhere we couldn't find it. Unexpected plan? Thanks,
I'm not hiding!
I'm not hiding anything!
I'm hiding anything!
I must reveal to Teteru the conclusive evidence that proves he's the killer. Panic talk action.
Shut up! That's impossible! Nonsense!
Do I just have to let go?
I don't know! There is Hilton! Where would the weapon be?
Meat on the bone.
This is the end!
Could the iron skewer have been hidden inside the piece of meat on the bone?
What are you saying? There's no way I'd hide anything. In a place like that?
That's clearly impossible! I mean, that's inside the food!
Impossible. That's what Byaki and I thought. That's why we overlooked.
People wouldn't have known that if the fishing was a dangerous item.
But in fact, the only place you could hide the weapon was inside the food that couldn't be inspected. Out of all the dishes you prepare, the only one that could hide a weapon as long as an iron skewer is the meat on the bone.
True.
What now?
I'm using my right to remain silent.
There's no way that exists here. We need to confirm this now.
So if we eat that tasty looking piece of meat and find the iron skewer inside, bullseye!
All right. Monokuma or Monami, one of you hurry and bring over that piece of meat.
1 minute. Just give me 1 minute. I'll eat the
whole thing. Is that allowed?
Wait, now hold on a second. Time out.
What are you doing? Hurry up and bring it over.
About that.
Huh? Where did Monokuma go?
I'm right here. I'm already eating it. Ah, a bear that eats meat! Wait, now that I think about it, that's pretty normal.
What is this?
So yummy!
Damn it! That's my meat!
I've never eaten anything like it in my entire life! The taste brings me back to my days in the wild.
This is bad! Seriously, this is really bad!
My! There's something inside the meat! Look what came out!
Isn't that... Is that an iron skewer? Check it out.
Heck yeah, dude.
The sword of destruction! Encased in bone and sheathed in meat! It brought catastrophe unto Byakuya!
I know.
As expected of Teru Teru. Such a fantastic weapon from the ultimate chef.
You're wrong. I'm not the killer. I'm not the kind of person who would kill someone. I got it. You all set me up. You guys set me up so you could blame this on me.
Jeez, what a disappointment. Such an unseemly defense for an ultimate like you. Can you really call that hope?
Hey, Nagato. I'm sorry, but can you just be quiet?
Thank you.
Lisa, you're all nothing but a bunch of poor loudmouth fast food eating hicks.
You don't need to translate anymore. Somehow I can tell what he's trying to say.
Let's just deal with Nagato later. More importantly, we should first...
I guess we need to settle this. To do that, we need to go over the entire incident from beginning to end and make everything clear.
I agree. The entire incident. Then I can prove Teteru's crime. That's right. If we don't do that, we can't end this no matter how much time passes.
So, we need to do
it. Oh, jeez. Every case has one last feature to bring the trial to an end. This is the closing argument. In this phase, you'll be given a complete summary of the case. You'll have to reproduce the order of the case in a comic book.
Here's everything that happened in this case.
There we go. That took a while.
Let's try going over the whole incident, beginning with right after the party started. Yakuya had us gather in the dining hall of the old building near the hotel. He was extra cautious about a murder occurring that night because of a threatening letter he received. Therefore, he decided to throw a party so he could monitor us.
Got it.
Though one person didn't come, the rest of us assembled at the dining hall, and the party was underway.
Got it.
At that time, the trap set by a certain someone was already in motion. They plugged three irons into the outlets in the storage room, which nearly kept the power usage. Additionally, they prepared something else that would activate at 11:30 p.m. The air conditioners in the office and dining hall. They had already set the timers for these. Thanks to the irons maxing out the power usage, the breaker was tripped when the air conditioners kicked on.
Yes, that we know.
Since the windows in the old building were covered, the blackout plunged the dining hall into total darkness. But when that happened, Byakuya took out a specific item that he brought in his case.
Yeah.
That item was the night vision goggles.
Got it.
Byakuya was so concerned about a murder occurring that he brought a variety of security equipment with him.
Yes.
When he put on his night vision goggles, Byakuya witnessed a certain someone making a suspicious move. He saw Nagito guiding himself with the desk lamp's power cord so he could get under the table. That's right. Everything up to that point was all part of Nagito's plan. The murder warning to Byakuya, the source of the blackout, it was all Nagito.
It's true.
While the blackout was happening, someone else, the real killer, began making their move in the kitchen.
Yes.
The killer probably already knew about Nagito's plan, so they knew a blackout was coming. That's why the killer prepared all the items they would need to commit their crime in the dark beforehand. They needed a light source, which was provided by the portable stove in the kitchen. They needed a weapon, too. This had also been hidden in the kitchen beforehand. The long iron skewer used in the churrasco dish. The killer hid that inside that meat with the bone in it. With the weapon and portable stove in hand, the killer stepped out into the hallway. First, they closed the fire door in the hallway so the light source wouldn't peek toward the dining hall. Then, guided by the light, the killer headed toward the storage room and grabbed a specific item.
Got it.
That's right. A tablecloth to block the blood splatter.
Good idea.
With this, the killer finished their preparations and snuck under the... They probably turned off the portable cookie stove at that point, or left it near the entrance of the door. The floor in the dining hall is full of gaps, so there's no way they could have safely held a light source. But thanks to the glowing mark they painted earlier, the killer was able to get beneath the table. Under the table, Byakuya found the knife that had been hidden there. If only he had retreated, he probably wouldn't have gotten killed, but he had to retrieve that knife. And at that moment, the killer lurking beneath the floorboard stabbed straight up with the iron skewer. The killer had been waiting in the dark for the moment when the glowing paint began to move.
Huh.
After they murdered Byakuya, the killer purposefully shouted from beneath the floorboards to make it seem like they were still in the dining hall. Afterward, they came out from underneath the floorboards and rushed back to the kitchen.
Got it.
And then, after hiding the murder weapon in the kitchen, they rejoined the group as if nothing had happened. There's only one person who would have been able to commit this crime, especially if that person is someone who'd think of an unexpected way to hide a weapon inside food. Isn't that right, Teru Teru Hanamura?
Yep. Finally.
That's what happened. How the... This is a mistake. A mistake, I tell you. I would never kill anyone. Would never.
It seems this is the end.
GG, well played. Why is this picture still smiling? Oh, lordy me. I'll take the B, honestly. And look at those coins that I got. Honestly.
Whoops! I lost control of my wild side for a second. Well, putting that aside, let's move along to the nerve-wracking voting time!
Jesus Lord.
Now then, please pull the lever in front of you and cast your vote! Oh, just a reminder, make triple sure you vote for someone. If you don't vote, I'm gonna eat you up just like that meat from earlier!
Why did this happen?
Who will be chosen as the blackened? Such heart-pounding...
Yeah, Monokuma. GG, well played. Teru, I'm sorry, but you just can't go around killing people like that. It's not a thing. It's not a thing that you can do.
Correct!
I'm glad that's over, though. Gosh, that's stressful.
No.
I gotta get better at it, too. And I also gotta edit, like, all of these episodes that I just did. Oh, my goodness.
You've got it wrong. Hey!
I was only trying to stop Nagato from murdering one of you. Huh? Trying to stop? What do you mean?
I
spent all morning in the old building, preparing dishes for the party, and then I heard a weird laughter near the dining hall, and when I peeked over there, I saw him, Nagato, in the middle of his cleaning duty, putting that knife under the table. I had a bad feeling about it, so I continued to watch what he was doing. And when I saw him place the irons he brought in from the storage room and mess with the air conditioner timers, plus he was grinning, just grinning by himself the whole time, so I questioned him.
When that happened, he...
You caught me?
Oh, I've been caught?
What?
Been caught?
Hey!
Hey, what are you doing? What are you scheming? I'm planning to kill someone, of course. Huh? Teru, just so you know, it's pointless of you to stop me. If you stop me now, it doesn't matter. I will never give up. Whether it's tomorrow, or the day after tomorrow, or the days beyond that, I'll definitely start the killing.
Impossible!
What? No matter how much... How much you want to leave this island, that's just... That's... I see. So that's what you think.
Well...
Well, that's not it at all. This isn't about my survival. I just want the killing to start.
What?
What are you saying? I love everyone here. That's why I want to be of good use to them. All of the Ultimates, I admire them for being symbols of hope.
Amazing!
That's right. In the name of hope, I love everyone's talents to the bottom of my heart. That's why I don't want them to lose against something like killing. I want them to prove to me that hope will never lose, no matter how daunting the despair they face may seem. I want everyone to prove to me that hope will never lose to despair.
No.
Hey, what are you saying? I don't understand at all.
See,
isn't it typical of you to face a strong enemy? You'll become stronger yourself, which means the stronger despair you face, the stronger everyone's hope will become, right? I wanted to see that brightness, and in order to see it, I'm going to become everybody's stepping stone. I want to make your hope shine. It's as simple as that. That's right. I yearn for a powerful hope that can overcome any kind of despair.
Are you kidding me?
Don't tell me you're actually serious.
Man.
So you don't understand. That's fine. I don't really mind. I'm just an obsessed fanboy. So it's alright that this love of mine is unrequited. I suppose I can be called the ultimate fanatic.
Wait, no way!
There's something wrong with you. Really? Do you think so? Do you really think there's something wrong with me? But isn't that what love is? Nagito, what is the meaning of this? Explain it to me. I don't understand anything about the story at all.
See?
You see, if you have a favorite boxer, don't you want him to win against a strong opponent, or go fight against a strong opponent and win?
Don't fuck with me!
You better not compare us to that.
What?
Huh? Am I wrong? It's a given that trials are necessary to become strong, but the harsher the trial, the stronger you become, no? For mere humans, killing's is simply a tragedy, oh my goodness. But, for worthy humans, a trial such as this can elevate their status to even higher levels.
Amazing!
It's amazing to me that someone as untalented as myself can become that trial. There's no point in someone like me surviving. It's far more significant for me to die as everyone else's trial.
Great!
So there's no greater honor than becoming the foundation that your values may ascend to the brave new heights.
What's going on?
Stop it. You're seriously starting to piss me off.
What's going on?
I don't understand at all. Are you saying you basically wanted to commit murder for fun? No, it's not the same as killing someone for fun, but I guess it looked the same in your eyes. I have no intention of surviving and leaving you all to die. Is that why you don't mind when Teteru discovered your plan?
That's wrong.
Or perhaps it was intentional too, huh?
So
Nagito wanted to involve us in the killing. Plus, it'd be better for him if the mystery was more complex. Is that why you blatantly revealed your plan to Teteru? You wanted to pique Teteru's curiosity? You look forward to the mystery becoming more complex? Well, you're basically right. It's true I was looking forward to that. That's why I took the time to tell him about the secret passage I found while I was cleaning.
What?
That was your doing as well?
You're right.
I just casually mentioned it. Oh, it's dangerous if you fall, so don't get too close to it.
Hey!
This dude is seriously batshit crazy. He is. That's right, I tried to stop him, you know.
However.
But why did you kill Baku instead? I didn't know. Because Nagato was the one who was supposed to take that knife. That's why I thrusted the iron skewer there. But why is Byakuya the one who died? It was supposed to be Nagato, not him. Byakuya probably tried to stop Nagato from grabbing the knife. And then in place of Nagato.
Nope.
No, I don't think that's it. Huh?
Perhaps.
Byakuya was probably trying to protect Nagato.
What?
Wait, did you say?
See?
Because Byakuya said so, didn't he? As long as I'm the leader, I won't let anyone become a victim.
I will guide you all.
I will guide you all, that much I promise. Could it be, in order to keep that promise? As long as he was wearing the night vision goggles, I'm sure he saw someone moving under the floorboards. And that someone was aiming for Nagato.
Why?
So Byakuya gave his life to protect Nagato, even though he was trying to take the knife? I see. Byakuya is amazing. To keep a promise to protect everyone, he actually threw his own life away. And yet,
such despair.
I never expected an ending like this. Such despair. What? But we shouldn't let him die in vain. I'm sure everyone will become even stronger by overcoming this despair.
No way.
Could it be you knew Byakuya would protect you, so you set him up to fail? Something Jesus like Christ, me. Dude. How did this guy... What? Of course not. I'm not good at that calculating. I just took some precautionary measures. The results, they're just kidding.
No one expected.
But I never expected it to turn out like this. I never thought that I'd be the one to survive. Oh my goodness, dude. But since it was just my life that I'm saved, I didn't want to just waste it. So that's why I decided to help Teteru. Why? Well, because Teteru decided to commit his crime because he also had strong hope, right? Which means his actions were motivated by hope. He's still willing to go that far. He might truly be the person whose existence I was waiting for. I thought he might be the hope that could defeat any type of despair. In order to confirm it, I decided to help Teteru. What do you mean confirm? Just stop it already. Plus, I couldn't really help myself when I also empathized with Teteru. After all, he wanted to kill me, but he ended up killing Byakuya instead, you know? If I left him in that confused state, this trial might have been ruined, right?
Isn't that right?
But in order for our hope to grow, this trial was absolutely necessary. That's why I decided to help him. I told him, I don't care if I die, so you should just focus on escaping this island.
Right?
Those were my exact words to him before the investigation. Isn't that right, Teteru? In the end, it just wasn't enough, and this turned out to be a bad ending for Teteru. But you should be proud of yourself. You will not die in vain. You became a splendid sacrifice for everyone else so their hopes can grow even more powerful.
Impossible! Shut up! Shut up! Hey, hey.
Is it really okay for us to just leave this crazy bastard alone like this?
Huh?
Isn't it better if we just fucking kill him off?
Yeah!
Kill, he said. High school students are so violent these days. But the person who's gonna get killed now isn't Nagato. It's Teteru. Eh?
What's the matter?
You didn't forget, right? Because I told you at the beginning, right? If the blackened killer loses, a fun punishment awaits them.
Wait! No.
That was, wait, how should I put it? An accident. An act of self-defense. Not intentional. I feel it's impossible. It's not my fault.
Hey!
It doesn't matter if it's an accident, self-defense, or intentional. A murder is still a murder. And if you kill someone, that's murder.
Hey!
But there isn't any... But there isn't anything like sympathy judgments, extenuating circumstances, or maybe even prohibition.
Impossible!
I won't accept any of those claims. That's not...
Hey!
Hey, save me, you guys. I was only trying to stop Nagato, so...
Why you?
Be honest. After learning about Nagato's plan, you saw an opportunity, right? You probably thought nobody would find out if you killed him after messing up his plan, right? That's what you thought, right?
Wrong!
You're wrong, I... There's no way a person who has no malice would kill someone like that. In truth, you were just desperate to kill Nagato, and willing to sacrifice everybody else to survive, right? Just be honest already, at least in the end.
No.
That is...
Teteru.
Why?
If only you didn't try to kill Nagato, Byakuya would still be alive.
Answer me.
Why did you commit murder? Answer me, Teteru. I just wanted to go home.
I needed to go back home no matter what!
Because she's waiting for me. Mama is waiting for me at home. She's waiting all by herself for the day I graduate Hope's Peak Academy and I come home.
Okay, I'm going now. When I come back, I think we should talk again about opening an Aoyama and Azabu location.
Oh my, you're still talking about that?
Ooh, I'm serious. The Academy guarantees success for its graduates, right? So? I know it's gonna be difficult by yourself, but
Wait for me until then, okay?
Yes, you're right. Then I'll just have to do my best to keep the Hanamura Diner from going out of business until then.
Mom, you don't have to work so hard. What if you collapse again while I'm gone?
I'll be fine. Moms are strong. I won't lose to some illness.
I know that already.
I promised I would become a full-fledged cook and save Hanamura Diner. Mom is waiting for me to keep that promise. And even though she's sick and alone, she's still waiting for me.
That's why I need to go home!
Teteru. But if we were told our memories were stolen, and that several years have passed since our first day,
hey.
Then what happened to Hanamura Diner? What happened to my mom is still waiting for me? So you did believe what Monokuma said.
Damn it!
You were saying all along, it's okay, I'll never believe something like this. So why?
Wrong!
I still don't believe it. There's no way I can believe it. It has to be a lie.
That's why I wanted to go home!
I wanted to go home and confirm it. I wanted to make sure it was all just a lie. I wanted to make sure that I still have a place to call home. And that's where you effed up, dude. And that's where you effed up. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. It's not that Teteru didn't believe it, it's that he believed it more than anybody else here. And that's why he kept denying it. Because he believed it. He needed to deny it. Damn it, if only I knew how he felt, something like this would have never happened.
I
wanted to confirm by any means necessary, I had to do something. That's why, when I heard Nagato's plan, I found out he was going to kill someone if I left him alone. That's why.
Fine.
So you wanted the first kill.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, you guys. It doesn't mean I wanted to sacrifice any of you. It was the only thing I could do. I ended up killing Byakuya instead of Nagato. I see.
I think I'm the one who went crazy.
Teteru. Huh, so I wonder if I talked to him, if the murder would have never happened and we wouldn't need this class trial. Gosh, that brings up so many things. Now, as far as Mama's, so boring.
So, yoo-hoo!
Seems there's no point in basking in the afterglow, so let's hurry up and begin the punishment.
You can't!
Jeez, get out of my way!
Yeah. I'm surprised she didn't say it hurts so much.
Wait!
Not asking for forgiveness anymore, but
now
at least...
Then, I prepared a very special punishment!
For Teteru Hamura, the ultimate chef.
Hey!
Call me chef. No, wait. That's not what I...
Please!
Please tell me at least, what happened to Hanamura Daimer, to Mama?
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
Lies! I won't believe this!
I won't believe it.
Mama!
Alright, so Teteru's gone. Peace out, Teteru. I wonder what the punishment is. Murdered by helicopter? He said it was fast. Oh wait, what? Oh, he's gasoline. Hey, at least it like happened. What the fuck? Oh, wow. Jeez. Brutal. Super brutal. that oil or is that lava? It looks like lava to me. I feel like he would just die.
Extreme!
And at that, I'm going to have to end that episode. I don't know how long that was. But geez, I need to end it. I need to go to bed. I've been playing this for way too long. But thank you guys for watching. This has been Tubaplyr NegativeAE. Probably edit the last couple episodes so you guys enjoy them a little bit more. Because I don't want them to last forever. And I was a little bit quiet, so it was kind of boring. Because I'm getting tired. Hope you guys are having a good rest of your day. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you feel necessary. And leave a comment if you want to have a conversation. Because that's how we do things. And hope you guys are having a good rest of your day. Peace out, guys.